Hello, everybody. My name is Zuhour Mazinou. I am professor at National School of Applied Sciences. I received my PhD degree in electronics from the University of Limoges, France in 2008. My current research activities focus is on modeling and simulation techniques for large-scale integration RF circuits in IoT and IoV context. I'm very glad to share with you today an overview of my experience, and I hope that we will spend together a great moment of exchange and sharing. My talk today is about modeling and optimization of radio frequency components for IoT wireless communication. So let me give you a quick outline of my presentation. I will begin with a quick overview of some industry IoT definitions. Then we will see together a quick reminder of the IoT goal, its advantages and use cases. Then we will explore the five components of IoT implementation. I will present after the complete concept of behavioral modeling and simulation of radio frequency components for IoT wireless communication applications. The main point on this part is to see how we can optimize power and energy consumption in wireless communication chain. Then I will give an idea about the numerical implementation of these models. Finally, I will end by a conclusion. The main aim of this part is to give an overview of some industry definitions of the Internet of Things. IoT is a vision of any time, any place, anything for anyone. According to IDC, IoT is a network connecting devices or things that is characterized by autonomous provisioning, management, and monitoring. According to Cisco, IoT is the next evolution of the internet, connecting the unconnected people, processes, data, and things in your business today. McKinsey defines IoT as sensors and actuators connected by network to computing systems. These systems can monitor or manage behavior and actions of connected objects and machines. And at last, according to Internet of Things Journal, an IoT system is a network of networks where typically a massive number of objects, things, sensors, or devices are connected through communications and information infrastructure to provide value-added services via intelligent data processing and management for different applications. We will see the different applications together after. In simple words, Internet of Things IoT is an ecosystem of connected physical objects that are accessible through the Internet. So the ultimate goal of IoT is to automate human life. IoT popularity is governed by the value that it promises to create and the fast market growth. Let's see now the three major reasons why the world needs it. The scope of IoT is to create open platforms for connected smart objects designed to make building and deploying applications easier, faster, secure, and more accessible for everyone. It allows to create the low-power wide area sensors and actuator network systems for machine-type communications, smart cities, and ubiquitous sensor network applications. It contributes also to socio-economic development, such as in agriculture, health sector, and many more. Before we understand the impact IoT can have on our way of living, it's important to go through its advantages and disadvantages. The advantages of IoT span across every area of lifestyle and business. Here is a list of some of the advantages that IoT has to offer. The first advantage is that IoT improves customer engagement. We know that current analytics suffer from blind spots and significant flaws in accuracy, and as noted, engagement remains passive. So IoT completely transforms this to achieve richer and more effective engagement with audiences. The second advantage is the technology optimization. The same technologies and data which improve the customer experience also improve device use and aid in more important improvements to technology. So IoT unlocks a world of critical, functional, and field data. It also reduces waste. It makes area of improvement clear. Current analytics give us superficial insight, but IoT provides real-world information leading to more effective management of resources. Another advantage of IoT is enhanced data collection. So modern data collection suffers from its limitation and is designed for passive use. IoT breaks it out of those spaces and places it exactly where humans really want to go to analyze our work. It allows an accurate picture of everything. Both IoT delivers an impressive set of benefits. It also presents a significant set of challenges. Here is a list of some its major issues, such as security, privacy, complexity, and flexibility. The biggest disadvantage of IoT is that our lives will be increasingly controlled by technology and will be dependent on it. The younger generation is already addicted to technology for every little thing. Let's see together now IoT use cases. It has a lot of applications in various fields. Following are some possible IoT areas. However, it can be put to many more uses. IoT can be used in building and home automation, manufacturing, medical and healthcare systems, media, environmental monitoring, infrastructure management, energy management, and transportation. We see now five main components of IoT systems. As we said before, the IoT is the network of physical objects, devices, vehicles, buildings, and other items which are embedded with electronic software, sensors, and network connectivity. It enables these objects to collect and exchange data. The IoT implementation process includes five phases. At first, we have sensors, then networks, standards, intelligence analysis, and at last, intelligence action. In the next stage, we will focus only on this first stage, sensors. As we said before, the bigger concept of IoT is to connect all devices you own for maximum convenience and efficiency. IoT wireless technologies are designed for everyday people to get more from their technology. It is at the heart of IoT applications. IoT changes significantly the requirements for connectivity, mainly with regards to long battery life, low device cost, varying bandwidth requirements, extended coverage and support for a massive number of devices. One of the more required is the varying bandwidth. One, spectrum needs to be made available in a range of frequency bands to cater for various cases. Driven from this requirement, the main challenge here is to investigate and optimize accurate models for radio frequency components in IoT wireless communication context. Communication systems that we are interested on are all wireless systems, including telecoms and all radar and remote sensing applications. The communication system is a very large entity. It is schematically consisting of two segments. A so-called digital segment, which deals with all the operations related to the collection, processing, and restoring sensitive information. Then, an analog segment, which deals with the spatial transport of information packages. We focus our attention more precisely in these analog segments. We can observe that from the point of view of the complexity in terms of the number of transistors, we have millions of transistors in the digital segments and only a few thousands in the analog one. But paradoxically, to develop high performance communication systems, designers turn to analog segments. It requires the most design time. Our mission is thus to develop tools allowing the prediction and optimization of the basic functionalities of the analog signal, which are illustrated here, namely the generation of the carrier and time base, the modulation of information spikes, the frequency transposition, filtering and multiplexing of microwave channels, changing and connection, and radiation and reception of electromagnetic waves. The system is a complex structure. In order to try to control this complexity, we will generally adopt an approach of functional or structural hierarchical decomposition, as illustrated here. Subsystem, chip, function, circuit, and at last, component. Then we carry out a backward simulation macro modeling process from the component level to the system. We will thus finally analyze what is happening at the component level. From this analysis, we will develop the optimal component model, which will be used for the circuit level analysis. And so on, the process starts all over again until the system level. Now let's see the main simulation problem. If we analyze the analog segments of the communication system, we can highlight four main simulation problems, which are the simulation of the antenna, the multiplexer, the receiver, and finally the report layout aspect with the problems of connectors and box, as illustrated here in the case of a satellite payload. We will focus more specially on the receiver simulation problem. In the modern IT wireless communication, the model becomes complex. The simulation speed as well as accuracy decrease significantly. The accuracy of simulation of communication systems depends on the availability of models able to describe the behavior of the different components with a high level of precision. The solution today, therefore, involves the development of behavioral models which must combine simplicity and high accuracy. Behavioral modeling is useful to us both in the system size and phase and in the ascending validation phase. We will focus here only on the ascending validation one to go back from the circuit to the system and the system. Let's have now an idea about behavioral modeling principle. It consists in the description of the behavior of a complex device with a more simple but accurate enough function, linking the input and the output signals. In order to identify the input-output relationship, either circuit simulation results or measurements can be carried out. The goal here is to find a description of the device, that is to say a model which can be efficiently implemented in system level simulation software. Once the problem is posed in this way, we have three problems to solve here, which are the characterization of non-linearity, interstage mismatch effects, and envelope memory effects. We will focus our study on power amplifiers. Power amplifiers are nonlinear devices and are among the most critical elements of communication systems because they strongly impact the system performances in terms of DC consumption and signal distortion. Furthermore, their behavior is affected by complex phenomena like nonlinear memory effects. These effects can be classified into two categories. The first kind of memory effects implicate short time constants, which mainly correspond to RF matching circuits. These effects are named high-frequency memory effects. The second kind is due to long-time constants involved in thermal effects and electrical transients and envelope periods present in the BSM circuit. These effects are named low-frequency memory effects. These two kinds of memory effects are strongly linked, and the behavioral modeling of such phenomena is a quite important and difficult task to achieve. It is possible to characterize high and low frequency memory effects independently if particular stimuli are chosen. We will illustrate this with harmonic balance and envelope simulations of the design circuit of the power stage of an amplifier operating at 19 GHz. Here are some simulation characterizations. Considering the first frequency memory effect or short-term memory, CW signals are used. This is a static characterization of the device as illustrated in the left. They do not simulate low frequency effects due to the absence of envelope variations. These effects are highly highlighted by the variation of gain versus the RF carrier frequency. We can see here in the left side constant frequency amplifier gain curves, which will be different depending on the excitation frequency. Low frequency memory or long-term memory effects can only be seen with signals with two or more carriers. Significant variation in the characteristics of CI are observed here in the right side as a function of the frequency derivation. Resonance phenomena of several dB and asymmetry of the left and right intermodulation terms are observed, which testifies to the great complexity of this phenomenon. The techniques for modeling these effects as Romulus and Romaine a major research subject. So the purpose of the behavioral modeling is to find a non-linear function linking input and output baseband signals. We have to find a non-linear function linking each sample time of the input signal to the output. Solid state amplifier behavioral modeling is a hot research topic with a tremendous amount of proposed models. Behavioral models based on Volterra series have shown their excellent capacity to reproduce the memory effect. Now, we will see how we can numerically integrate these models in system simulators. The use of direct integration techniques like Newton code to compute the Volterra model or impulse response model can suffer from the problem of computing time. The solution is to rewrite the formulation of the model in a different way. The basic idea is to extend the Volterra kernel or response impulse using the decomposition of the kernels in basic functions. These techniques enable us to convert the integral into a series of differential equations. The first problem is that of the nonlinear Fourier integral. As you see here, mathematically, the Volterra kernel is a function with two variables, input power and the frequency. Here we decompose the kernel following the frequency directional function by the approximation. In setting the rational function in the Fourier integral, we transform the integral into a differential equation. So to integrate the model, we use the numerical integration techniques used in the circuit and system simulators. We use the GIR formula, which presents an excellent compromise between accuracy and stability. The final form of the model takes this form. So to conclude, IoT is a vision of any time, any place, or anyone. Wireless connectivity is at the heart of IoT applications. The main challenge today is to investigate and optimize accurate models for radio frequency components in IoT wireless communication context. The accuracy of simulation of communication systems depends on the availability of models able to describe the behavior of the different components with a high level of precision. So the solution today, therefore, involves the development of behavioral models, which must combine simplicity and high accuracy. Thank you for your attention.